guys, Christy Moore here with moorefitness.com. Today's workout is going to be a fun one. We're going to start with a 12-minute HIIT where we're going to be doing four different moves for 50 seconds on, 10 seconds off, all kind of cardio-based moves that get your heart rate up. We're going to be doing that for 12 minutes, so we're going to be repeating it three times. Then after that, we're going to go into an 18-minute increasing rep AMRAP. So we're going to have five different moves. They're kind of multiple based moves that you're going to be starting. You're going to start with one rep of each, then two, then three, then four, then five. You're going to get to as many rounds as you can, increasing your rep by one each round for 18 minutes. So that should be nice and challenging for you all. I have a set of 12 and a half pounds and a set of 15 pound dumbbells. I'm going to start with my 15s. So I want you to start with heavy weight, and if you need to drop down when you're going on through the movement, then you can. I just went for a quick sprint, 1 mile sprint, finished in just over 7 minutes. I'm going to stretch now. I want you to do the same. I want you to get some sort of warm up. Then we're going to come back and start the 12 minute HIIT. Okay guys, so we're going to start with, I want you to make sure you read the description below so you know these moves, kind of go over the video if you need to. We're going to get right into it. 50 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We're starting with those lateral jump lunges. Okay, 3, 2, and 1. So it's over, switch. I want you to try to go, you should be nice and warmed up and stretched. So at this point, you're moving as quickly and swiftly as you can with correct form. Twenty-five seconds. 15, 8 seconds, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now we have jack leg push-ups. So we're going down, jack leg push-up. 3, 2, and 1. That's 1. If this is too much for you, remember you can always do the push-up on your knees if you need to, then in and out with the legs. Push up, in and out. If you need to go to your knees, hop back up for the in and out. Twenty seconds. Twelve seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay. We are doing 4 high knees, 2 sumo squat jumps. Okay. 3, 2, and 1. 3, 4, 1, 2. Make sure those feet are pointed out with those jumps. Sitting all the way down and up. Explode up. So you can see my profile. Fifteen. 5 seconds. Okay. 10 second rest. Power all the way down to the floor. Pop up into a squat. 2 and 1. Going down. So you're never really coming up. 25 seconds. seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, guys, back to those lateral jump lunges. Switch. So you're staying nice and low. What I tell my kids, what I tell my clients, when you're doing this move, your head should stay leveled. So you're not coming up, then moving. You're staying low each time. So you're switching in a low position. 25 seconds. 20 seconds. Seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Oh, my heart rate. Okay. Down. Jack leg push-ups. Four, three, two, one. All right, hopping up. Four high knees, two sumo squat jumps. Down and up. Then we start our last round. All the way down, guys. Chest goes to the floor, then you pop up. One. Okay. Okay. Sorry, guys. I think someone was trying to call me. Okay. We're going to do lateral jump lunges again. 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. This is your last round here before we move on to the AMRAP for 18 minutes. Seconds. Keep it nice and low. You're almost there. 20 seconds. 12 seconds. 8 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds. Push up jacks. Three seconds, 2 and 1. Last time you're doing this. Seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Holy cow. Push-ups are the hardest things to go into after your heart rate is up. 4 high knees, 2 sumo squat jumps. 3, 2, and 1. Hold those knees hip height. So I don't want to see any of this. You want your knees to be hip height. 20 seconds. 15. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1. 10 second rest. Going to your last move. Powering down up to a squat to finish this hit. Chest to the ground. Bring those knees and feet right below your shoulders as quick as possible. If this is too advanced, you can always come down, bring your knee up, come down, bring your knee up. Fifteen. 8 seconds. Three, two, one. Okay, guys. That completes that hit part of this workout. So, I want you to take a second, drink some water, get any sort of extra stretching you need done. Don't take too long of a rest, but take whatever you need. And then we're gonna get right into the 18-minute AMRAP. You're gonna be going at your own pace. I want you to push yourself. Try not to take too many rests. Okay, again, 5 moves. Make sure you're looking below for the moves. Make sure you watch the video if you don't know what any of the moves are, so you can move quickly through the movement. We're gonna begin, so let's get this party started. Okay, guys, we're about to start this. Again, I'm using my 15s to start, and I'm feeling a little saucy, so I decided to put on my 12-pound weighted vest. We'll see how long I can keep this puppy on. Again, we're gonna begin right as I press this. So grab your weight, starting with that one Manmaker. Remember, you're doing 1 rep of each of these to start, okay? 3, 2, and begin. Modify where you need. You know where you're at. Going at your own pace. Curtsy lunge, bicep curl, one on each side. Burpee. Chest to the floor, 2 forward lunges. That's 1 rep. Squat thruster twist, grabbing this guy. Twist, that's both of them on each side is 1. Okay, cross under to Spiderman in a plank position, touching your forearm, touching your elbow. That's one rep. Now we're on to round two. Two man makers. You see how this is going, guys, right? You're gonna go through the first few rounds pretty quickly. Then it'll start getting real as each movement gets tougher and tougher. Those man makers are never easy. I don't care how advanced you are. And these 15 pounds, no joke. Okay. Again. Two burpees. Burpee booty, forward lunges. Hands behind your head. Second burpee. Squat thruster twist. Coming all the way down in that squat, guys. Pushing up. Want those elbows, try to get them to touch your knees each time. Did I do two of those? I don't know if I did. Okay, here we go. Sorry about that. Cross under. And then again. Okay, round three. It helps to yell out the round you're in, guys, so you know. Round three. Three man makers. That's two push-ups, two rows. Squat press. This is round three. The second one. Number three. Bicep curl, curtsy lunge. One, two, three. Burpee, two forward lunges for three. Chest to the floor. Thruster twist. One. Two. Three. Three. Cross unders. Spiderman for three. That's one. Power through this, guys. If you're going ahead of me, perfect. You're still on round three, no worries. Go at your own pace. Two. Three. 4 curtsy lunge bicep curls. Make sure you're stepping your foot all the way out to the side like you're bowling a ball. 2 elbows at your side. 3 4 Burpee, 2 forward lunges for 4. Squat thrust or twist seems so easy, but this weight is killer. Okay, 4, 1, 2, 3. Cross unders, Spiderman. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Okay. All right. Back to Manmakers for 5. That's the halfway mark, guys. 5. One second. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, curtsy lunge. Gotta get these people to stop texting me while I'm working out. 1. 1. 2. 2. We're on the 5th round. 3. 3. 4, 4, 1 more, 5, 5, 1 burpee, 2 forward lunges. There's so much sweat on this mat right now. Okay, 1, 2, phone's ringing. Keep going. 5. Okay. Now, squat, thrust, or twist. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. Cross under Spiderman for 5. Then we move on to round 6. Cross under Spiderman. 2, 3, 4. One more. 5. If you're challenging yourself with a weight, guys, with the weight you're using, your arms should feel like jello now. Okay? I'm gonna stick to these 15s. Really struggling here, but I'm gonna see how far I get. 6 man makers now. You have about 6 minutes left, guys, of this 18-minute AMRAP. 2/3 done. That's 1. Curtsy lunge. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. 6, 6. Okay, burpee, 2 forward lunges for 6. Burpee, 1. Burpee, 2. Burpee, 3, four, five, one more. All right, guys, squat thruster for 6. Oh my gosh. 2 minutes, 30 seconds. Here we go, 15th. 1, 2. Yeah. cross under. And Spiderman. Oh, less than 2 minutes to go, guys. You're almost there. One. Two. Three. Keep your belly button pulled in. Four. Moving on to round seven, guys. A minute 20 left. Less than that. I'm using my 12s because I want to get through a few rounds of these. Not a few rounds, but through a couple. Manmakers to start. For seven. 1 minute left. Six. Five. Almost there, guys. Finishing it off. Three, two, one. Oh boy, guys. That is it. Oh my Lord. You guys, awesome job. I'm just gonna like step up to show you what is happening here. This is soaked. Okay, just so you know, you guys are working, I'm working just as hard as you to give you an idea of what and how you can challenge yourself using the 12-pound vest, 15-pound dumbbells, for most everything. Really work. That's the only way you're going to see changes, guys, is if you challenge yourselves. Now, I'm going to bring you an additional ab circuit right after this. So we're gonna be doing a few different moves for 30 seconds on, no rest, okay? We're gonna be going through it three times. So get on your mats, get dried off, and we'll get back to the last part of the workout. Okay guys, so I normally don't do ab workouts that are separate from my workouts, so this one's gonna be a treat. You can either do this 30 seconds on for each move, and we have six moves, so it'll take you about 9 minutes, or you can try it for reps and do 50 reps on each side, 50 reps for each movement. And it'll probably take you around the same amount of time. So we're gonna begin, I mean a little bit longer for the reps, but not that much longer. 30 seconds, you're gonna start with oblique crunches. Three, two, and begin. Okay, up. Make sure you're breathing throughout this. Don't hold your breath. Your knees nice and bent, 90 degrees with your hips. 8 seconds. We're gonna go right into the other side. Three, two, one. I'm gonna flip over so I can see my timer. Here we go, and begin. Right after this move, you have 20 seconds left. You're gonna be going right into bicycle crunches. Now for bicycle crunches, I want you to go slow. I don't want you going fast. I want you to keep your elbows out to the sides, as I will show you, and not crunched up, okay? For an option for people who have lower back pain, you can drop your heel with each extension. Two, one, so on your back. So it'll look like this. Dropping your heel each time, nice and slow. Really focus on those abdominals. Really focus on the movement all the way here. It should feel nice and tight. 8 seconds. Four, three, two, One, bend your right knee, extend your right leg, left leg, and touch your shin with your opposite arm. Again, breathe out as you come up. So it's a continuous breath. If this is hurting your neck at any point, you can always take one hand and gently put it on the back of your head. Not on your neck, on the back of your head. Our next move is going to be moving to the other side. 3, 2, 1, switch. Other side. Same movement. Crossing over. The next move after this, which is going to complete the first round, is going to be a butterfly crunch. So your feet will be together and it's like a diamond shape. And you're going to put your hands behind your head and crunch up, or you can extend your arms and try to touch each knee. And I'll show you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So you can be here. Breathing out every time you come up, or here. If you want to keep one hand extended, one hand behind the head, that is fine as well, but make sure you're breathing. 10 seconds before we go right back into those oblique crunches. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And back to your obliques. Keep those knees nice and parallel. Parallel to that arm up top. 15 seconds. Feeling that crunch here. 10 seconds here. 7 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, right to the other side here. You have 18 seconds before you go into those bicycle crunches, nice and slow and controlled, feeling each movement, guys. And really think about really engaging that core, pulling that navel in towards your spine, really engaging. 2, 1, right into those bicycle crunches, keeping your elbows open to the side, dropping your knees if you need, or just keep them up and elevated. The other option too, for those who don't want to keep the legs off the floor, is to keep it here and bring extension like this. One knee at a time. You're still working your abdominals, guys. Okay? Depending on what your level is. 4, 3, 2. One knee is bent, extending to the opposite side. Now we're doing 3 rounds of this, but by all means, if you want to take it to a 4th round for 12 minutes, 5th round for 15, and then do so. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, switch. Butterfly crunches are next after this, and then we start our last and 3rd round. Four, three, two, one, and butterfly crunches. Feet are together. Extend if you care to at your knees. Really think about the movement, guys. Think about where the movement's coming from, feeling those abdominals engaged. They should feel nice and strong. 3, 2, back to those oblique crunches, last round. Seconds here. 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, one, and switch to the other side. Switching down here. Twenty seconds. Ten seconds, right into those bicycles. Eight, five, four, three, two, one, and bicycle crunch. We have the opposite hand to shin touch. Four, three, two, one. Bend the knee. Opposite hand comes to the shin. These are some simple moves. And a lot of times people say, like, keep moving, guys. A lot of times people will say, the movements I use in a lot of my workouts are very simple but effective, and that's what I'm going for here. Three, two, one, switch sides. I love doing advanced moves too, and you know what, I'll probably start doing a little bit more advanced videos, but I want everybody to know that they can do my workouts. Even in my classes, people will say, oh, you know, I've heard your classes are so tough, you know, I'm just a beginner. And I tell them each time, you know what, you can start in any of my workouts at any level. You just modify where you need to modify. Even if it's just holding a plank when everyone else is doing push-ups. Okay, last 30 seconds here. Butterfly crunch. So never feel intimidated. And if you have ideas for workouts that you'd like me to do, then send them along, because I'll do them. And I'll record them and put them out there for you guys. I get a lot of inspiration from my clients too, and what they can do. Try to pick things that I know the masses will be able to do, but also appeal to everybody else. And the end, guys. Get a nice stretch here. And definitely stretch after you work out, guys. Finish doing whatever stretches you want to. You know, if you're up to doing another, like for me, you know, go for another 1 mile sprint or something like that, which I'm not going to do, but you know, finish your workout strong. This has been about an hour here. So anyway, hope you guys have a great day. Enjoy yourselves, be safe, and I'll check you next time.